Education is the process which aids learning, acquiring knowledge and skill to one's character. Hi everyone, here is Vijay. As we all are aware, with the crisis the world is going through, which has forced us to keep away from each other, and it is because of the pandemic, COVID-19, the coronavirus. There are various ways of utilizing this time by staying safe at home, where you can develop your hobbies, learn new things like music, reading, or coming up with the talents you are strong in. Alfonso School is here to add something innovative and creative, that is Alfo Stay Home Safe E-Learning. So today we'll be getting acquainted with a writing skill in English, that is how to write a letter, which will help you throughout your life, and as a student of standard 10th, it can help you to grab maximum marks. So let us begin with the letter writing. As you all are aware, letters are of two types. The first one is formal letter writing, and the second one is the informal letter writing. Now the letters that include in this category, that is the formal letter writing, are the letters that are official, business, complaint letters, thanksgiving letter, letters written to any educational institutes, all include in this category. And in the informal letters, the letters that you write to your parents, to your relatives, or maybe to your friends. Now we will be seeing the format of the formal letter. This is how your page will be. This is the left margin. This is what you are supposed to do, draw, that is the right margin, and on the top you have your top margin, and this is the last line of your page. Now when you are writing a formal letter, few elements you have to keep in mind. The elements are, first one is the addressor. Now the addressor is the person who is writing the letter. For example, as a student you are writing the letter, so here you have to write your address. So you begin with the first line, that's your name. If the name has been given in the question paper, you are supposed to write the given name and the given address, and if it is not given, you can write imaginary name and imaginary address with the city or the town, and the addressor should end with the date on which you are writing the letter. Suppose for example, if you are writing the letter on 15th April, so the letter addressor's column should end with 15th April 2020. The next thing what you are supposed to do is, you are supposed to leave a line. Maybe in the previous classes you must have learned about writing the addressor on the right hand corner, but now since we have adopted the modern way, that is the American style of writing letters, so everything will be coming to the left and close to the margin. So after the addressor you are supposed to leave a line. This X or the cross that I have put, it is for leaving the line. The next thing that you are supposed to write is the addressee. Now who is the addressee? Addressee is the person to whom you are addressing the letter, to whom. Now when you are addressing the letter, the first thing what you are supposed to do is write the word to, and in the next line you are supposed to write the designation, the post to whom you are addressing the letter. For example, it can be the editor, the principal, the class teacher, the manager, the police inspector. So you are writing the letter, you are addressing the letter to the post. So that post has to be written here. Then next comes the office and the city. Again, after the address C, you are supposed to leave a line. And the third element in the formal letter is the subject. Don't forget, each new element you have to begin from close to the margin. So subject here, close to the margin, and that should be in block letters, that is capital, after that colon. And this subject should give an idea to the person whom you are addressing the letter about the intention or the purpose of the letter. So in very few words, you are supposed to write in the subject the purpose or the intention. Suppose if you are writing a job application, now you must have come across an advertisement in the newspaper or some of the media. So if you are writing a letter for a job, if it is a job application, you have to give the reference. So reference should come below the subject. So here is the reference, but before that, again you are supposed to leave a line. The cross, the X that I am showing here, you are supposed to leave a line there. And then next comes the reference, REF, that is the short form, full stop and colon. Now reference, from where you have come across the advertisement, it may be in the local newspaper or any of the sites. So you can just say here, your advertisement, full stop, that is short form, abbreviation of advertisement, in the local newspaper. Your advertisement in the local newspaper. And then you have to underline. After reference, that means you are writing this letter against this reference. Again, you have to leave a line. So here, subject followed by reference, if it is. And then next one is the salutation. Salutation is the greetings. Salutation is the greetings, like respected sir / madam. And then comes the body, but before that you are supposed to leave a line. And then comes the fourth element, is the body. Sorry, fifth element is body of the letter. Now when you begin the body, in the first paragraph, this body can be 2 to 3 paragraphs, you can write in 2 to 3 paragraphs. In the first part, you have to introduce yourself and you have to bring it to the notice of the person to whom you are addressing the letter, the purpose, the intention of the letter. So that should be in the first paragraph. So first paragraph, which you have to begin right from the margin. Here you have to introduce yourself and you have to make use of polite words to the point, and you have to be very brief in this letter. So the first paragraph is about self-introduction and the purpose or the intention you are writing the letter. Then in the second paragraph, but again when you begin the second paragraph, you are supposed to leave a line. And second paragraph can be a concluding paragraph. Now in the concluding paragraph, what you are supposed to write is, suppose if you are writing a letter to the police inspector regarding the frequent robbery that is taking place in your area, so what do you expect the police inspector to do? You can request him to have patrolling very often in your area, or to set up a police station in your area to avoid the robbery that is taking place in your area. Suppose if you are writing this letter to the editor, now what do you expect the editor to do? You can just ask the editor to highlight your problem in his or her esteemed newspaper. So this is what you are expecting. So the concluding paragraph should be, what are your expectations from the person to whom you are addressing the letter? And then after the concluding paragraph, what you are supposed to do is, again you are supposed to leave a line here. And after the concluding paragraph, the last element, that is subscription. Now what you are supposed to write in subscription? You can write yours faithfully, you can write yours truly, or also you can write yours sincerely. Any one of this word you can make use. After that you are supposed to sign here, and then you have to write the name that you have written on the top. So the same name will come here. This is how you have to write the formal letter. Now what are the elements? If you see here, first one is the addresser, that is you. Second one is the addressee, that is to whom you are addressing the letter. Third one is the subject. Fourth one, if you are writing against any reference, that reference has to come. Fourth one. Fifth one is the salutation. Sixth one is the body of the letter, and the last element, that is seventh one, is the subscription. So if you present this formal letter in this way, your chances increase of grabbing more and maximum marks in this writing skill. Now let's come to informal letter. Now how to write an informal letter? What is the difference between the format of formal and informal? Very few changes you will note. This is the page, your normal page where you write the letter. This is how the page ends with the last line, and this is the top margin. Now what are the similarities between the formal and the informal letter? Here you are writing addresser. In the informal letter too, you have the addresser. Addresser, that is the person who is writing the letter. As a student, since you are attempting this question, your address. If it is given in the question paper, you are supposed to write the same address. If it is not given, you have to write imaginary address, and the last line should end with the date. For example, if you are writing on 15th April, the date 2020. Now what are the things that you have to eliminate from formal while writing informal? Here you are not writing addressee. Addresser, yes. Addressee, no. Subject or reference, no. Fourth one, salutation. Yes, you are going to write salutation. Now what can be the salutation? Suppose if you are writing the letter to your parents, dear mother, dearest mother, my dear mother, my dearest mother, you can make use of any of these words. Same thing to the relatives too. Dear uncle, dear aunt, my dear uncle, my dear aunt. Or if you are addressing the letter to friend, any of your friend. Now when you are writing the letter to the friend, even you are addressing to friend, in the salutation you can say dear friend. You can't write friend and name of the friend together. You have to either say dear friend, or if you are writing a letter to your friend whose name is Raj, you have to say dear Raj. You can say dearest Raj, you can say my dear Raj, you can say my dearest Raj, but you can't say dear friend Raj. So salutation, you can begin here. I am writing here addressing for you to understand dear father. Now you can see in informal letter you have lots of space. That means you can write as much as you can in this letter. You can make the letter elaborative. Now don't forget the difference between the formal letter and the informal letter. In the formal letter, you are writing it with a purpose, with a cause, with a reason. But here, the person who is writing the letter and the letter to whom you are addressing, both are curious to know about each other. So you can make it elaborative. You can express yourself. But here you can't express. You can't make use of exclamatory words here. But here you can make use. Here you can use imperative sentence. You can advise, suggest, request. Here you have to only request. Here you have to use only polite words. But here you can make use of all four types of sentences. You can make use of statements, you can make use of interrogatives, you can make use of imperatives, you can make use of exclamatories. But here you are restricted with the only statements and to the point and very brief. So here you get lots of space for body of the letter. And then here you can begin, I think so 3 to 4 paragraphs you can easily write here. But don't forget to leave line after each paragraph. Don't forget to leave the line after each paragraph. Here too. Second paragraph can be utilized for the purpose of the letter. Second paragraph can be utilized. In the first paragraph, you can just greet yourself. You can give your regards to each one of the family members or to whom you are addressing the letter. That can take place in the first paragraph. But in the second paragraph, you are supposed to write the purpose, the intention of the letter. And third one, you can conclude. Conclusion means very soon we'll be meeting, then come here for the vacations. I am eagerly waiting for you to see or to meet you or your family members. So in that way, you can conclude this third paragraph. So here you can see the difference between the formal letter and the informal letter. Here you get more space to express yourself, whereas here in the formal letter you are restricted. Then next comes, what is the next element that you have to conclude as the formal letter? It is the subscription. Subscription, yes. So how you will end the letter? You may say, suppose you are writing the letter to your father, yours loving son or daughter. If you are writing the letter to your uncle or aunt, you can say yours loving nephew or niece. You can say yours loving friend if you are writing the letter to the friend. And the same thing again, that is the signature and the name that you have written on the top. Hope so. Things are absolutely clear for you, that is the difference I have tried to bring between the formal letter and the informal letter. Don't forget these elements, and if you present it in a neat way, I think so, you can grab maximum marks. So all the best, till then, see you.